next two number one overall picks in Nick and Chase. Do you think that's a possibility?
Definitely. They both have great potential. Those two, they're very capable of doing it because, you know, they definitely put in the work. It's also, you got Coop, who could also become that, because Coop worked extremely hard as well. And you got Jayshon. The real sleeper is probably Davon. You know, he has a lot of ability as well. So not to single just anybody out, but I feel like it's a lot of great potential on the defensive line next year.
So what exactly makes you say that? Because obviously going into this year, we were all just talking about all you guys were coming back this line this year, and it's going to be an exodus on that line. I know a lot of guys have gotten the playing time, but what makes you so confident that they're going to fill the shoes?
I mean, it's everybody tries to get a bite at everything that you can, because when it's your opportunity, you just want to shine like everyone else, so you have guys who are out here grinding and working just as hard as the older guys, and everybody just wants to shine.
Taekwon, I imagine you saw what happened with Ryan Shazier on Monday. I believe you were teammates with him first year here. Have you had a chance to be in touch with him at all?
Not as of recently, but he's in my prayers. It's insane, but I'm definitely praying for the best. I hope to see him out there one day again.
What went through your mind when you saw all of that happen?
Instantly you just think about, you just saw one of your brothers go down, someone who, you once built a relationship with, and just instantly just think it was crazy. I definitely felt bad at the moment for sure. Just kind of messed up.
Does it scare you at all playing this game, knowing that risk is always there?
I'm not sure. I've never really considered any type of risk playing this game, because I think the moment you think about getting hurt or something like that, something bad happens. If you plan to be careful, then it's probably not gonna be for you. You play to have fun. I'm not playing to worry about my health.
What was something
it was cool. We swung at it, made a case for it, but definitely hurt a lot of feelings, but got in a good bowl, so playing against a tradition-rich program, ready to go. A lot of guys are ready to play in this game. It's still a big time game, so every opportunity I get, I cherish.
When they flashed Alabama's logo on the screen, not sure. Did you get on the right side of things the last couple times?
Yeah. It's a blow. That's all. Like I said, eventually I moved on. Went had dinner, being with my friends. Me, Tracy, and Jalen. Went and had dinner. Came back and went to work. Now we're working on beating USC.
And now is that all in the past? All USC, you're all excited about that?
Yeah. At some point you gotta move forward, You just can't necessarily dwell on it. We should be, all that talk. Now the focus is on beating USC and making the brotherhood stronger, because it's my last shot, go out the ring on the Cotton Bowl.
What kind of challenges does Sam Darnold bring? How much have you gotten to watch of him so far this year?
Honestly, I haven't watched much of Sam Darnold. I honestly haven't watched a lot of Pac-12 ball, you know. So, I mean, but based on the film I have watched thus far, he's a good quarterback, you know. They have a lot of great things that they do, you know. He can sling the rock around. Definitely say that. He makes a lot of plays on third down. You know, he's a competitor, as you can see. Third down, he drops back. You know, if it's not there, he extends the play very well. His O-line buys him a little more time. He'll either run for it or, you know, just try to make a play. I mean, he's a competitor.
Obviously.